In a world without streetlights, television, or other distractions, the moon is hard to ignore. It's easy to see why in so many cultures around the world, throughout time, the lunar landscape has been as familiar a face as any other in the community. Some stories describe the moon as if it were a person, connected to and connecting cycles of life. To the First Nations Australian Yolngu people, the moon is a man named Ngalindi, who is chased by his wives, dying and regrowing every month. Moon cycles tell many cultures around the world how to divide their year. For example, the moon calendar of the Lakota, a Native American tribal nation, has 13 months of 28 days each. There are over 575 tribal nations in the United States, each having its own naming systems. However, the names of the months are often closely connected to events in the natural world. The Hijri calendar, or Islamic calendar, is a lunar calendar in which each moon cycle is a month. It is used to determine when special observances for Muslims, such as Ramadan, must take place. With 12 months in a year, the Hijri calendar year is around 355 days. This is shorter than a solar year, or the length of time it takes for the Earth to complete an orbit around the Sun, which is around 365 days. Some calendars adjust for the difference between lunar months and solar years. In the Chinese calendar, each new moon marks the beginning of a month. Most years have 12 months, but there are occasional leap years containing 13 months to bring the calendar year back in line with the solar year and the seasons. So, Chinese New Year, which is the first day of the first month, always falls on the new moon that appears in late January or early February. Tracking the time it takes for the moon to orbit the Earth once is highly important for many cultures and religions. It provides us with the basis for determining a month. But why does the moon's face go through a cycle of changes every 4 weeks? And what do those changes look like? The moon orbits the Earth in a journey that takes around 28 days. It also turns once on its axis about every 28 days. Slowly enough that the same face always looks down on Earth. We see the moon because light from the sun is reflected off its surface. Because it's a sphere, the moon is always half lit and half in shadow. You might have noticed that the moon looks a little different from 1 week to the next. Sometimes it's full and bright, then it's a sliver of light, and then it's merely a dark shadow. Well, it looks like the moon is changing shape. It's actually just changing position as it orbits the Earth. These changes are called the phases of the moon. When the moon is here, we see only a small part of the lit side. This is called the new moon. As the moon moves, we see more of it. This is a waxing crescent moon. Now we can see half of the moon. This is called the first quarter moon. What we are actually seeing is half of the lit side only. And when the lit half is fully exposed, we have a full moon. Then we see the third or last quarter moon. The moon moves continually through its phases as it completes its orbit around the Earth. When the Earth, Moon, and Sun are lined up like this, the Moon blocks the Sun from our view, and we get a solar eclipse. When they're like this, the Earth throws a shadow over the Moon, and we get a lunar eclipse. partial eclipses happen only when the moon's orbit is in the same plane as the Earth. Partial solar and lunar eclipses usually occur a few times a year, although they are not always visible from every part of the Earth. Some cultures interpret eclipses as warnings of events, both good and bad, in times to come. People of the Western Torres Strait Islands, located between mainland Australia and Papua New Guinea, describe eclipses as the ghost taking the spirit of the moon, and see it as an omen of war. The Yolngu people of Elko Island, off the coast of Arnhem Land in northern Australia, view a solar eclipse as an embrace between the Sun Woman and the Moon Man. These stories might not precisely describe the physics of eclipses, but they show the importance of movements of the moon and other celestial bodies in the lives of humans. Like many natural cycles, the cycles of the moon play a range of roles in cultures across time and across the globe, from guiding us through the darkness of night, to helping us keep track of the days, to keeping us entertained and connected to other people through storytelling.
If you liked this video, you can find it and so many more at clickview.net. Sign up for free today.